doctor Dios, Raulito, estamos a punto de comenzar la conferencia de prensa de Hillary, ¿no? Así que estoy lista para hacerle todas las preguntas.
Hi, Hillary. I'm Vanessa from Disney Channel. I have two questions for you. First, how did Mexico receive you?
How did Mexico receive for the first show, you mean?
Yes.
I think it was good. You know, I didn't really get to see any reviews, but I got to see the reaction of the fans, which is always the most exciting thing for me. And it was so much fun, you know. They were very, very loud, and it was a sold-out show, which was really exciting as well for me. And it's really crazy to come someplace so far away from home and see everybody knowing every single word to the songs, and just see how much support that they show me is really flattering and exciting.
Tell us about a little bit of the Most Wanted tour.
Well, we've pretty much toured all over with this. We started in America. We toured there for like 3 months, and then we went to Canada and to Europe and to Australia. And now here's our last stop. And it's exciting. It shows a lot of songs that are from previous albums and then also the new music.
Hillary Duff, en exclusiva como se los prometí, estoy muy emocionada de estar con ella, así que comencemos. Are you ready?
I am. I'm very excited for tonight. There's going to be a lot of people out there, and it's my first show in Mexico City, so very excited.
Primero que nada, Hillary, cuéntanos cómo te recibió México.
Well, you know, it's my first time in Mexico City, but we had two other shows that were in Mexico, and it's been so nice. It's really great to come so far away from home and see fans that are supporting you all over and knowing all the words, and they're very excited, I think.
Sabemos que estuviste en Guadalajara, en Monterrey, y ahora estás en el DF. Hoy es una gran noche y va a estar muy, muy divertida. ¿Cuál ha sido el lugar en donde mejor te han recibido?
I'm not sure. I think that they're pretty tied, you know. I'm going to be excited to see the outcome of tonight. I think tonight's one of the biggest venues, and I don't know. I don't think that I can choose because they were both really good.
¿Has probado la comida mexicana?
I have. Mexican food is one of my favorites, so it's really good to be here and get to eat so much of it.
Do you have favorite place? Chilaquiles.
Chilaquiles. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Yeah. That's what I like to eat for breakfast.
Oh, but,
I don't know. I love like all the rice and beans and the meats and everything. I'm really, like a really big fan of everything.
Hillary, cuéntanos un poquito sobre los planes que tienes a futuro.
Let's see, I've been touring for pretty much all this year, so I think when I get back to the States, I think I might be able to take a small break, and I have a movie coming out with my sister called Material Girls, and so we're going to have to start promoting that. And then I have a couple movies that, you know, we've been talking about, and it's just a matter of when we can fit them in between my touring schedule.
¿Cómo es un día de Hillary Duff desde que se despierta hasta que se duerme?
It depends on what I'm doing during the day. Today, I woke up and, you know, we had the show in Guadalajara and in Monterrey, and then after the show in Guadalajara, I flew to Los Angeles and I had a photo shoot that I had to do, and then I just flew back today, and so we had to wake up really early and get on a plane and drive here and start getting ready, and then we have like 2 hours of prep and then meet and greet and then get ready for the show and do sound check and try and eat something, and then we go on and do the show and we end around the rest.
You think you're going nowhere when you're walking down the street, acting like you just don't care, but life could be so sweet. But why you wanna be like that, as if there's nothing new? You're not fooling no one, you're not even fooling you. So walk a little slower and open up your eyes. Sometimes it's so hard to see the good things passing by. Why not? Why not?
You know, ¿qué recuerdos tienes de Lizzie McGuire?
I have really good ones. It's really funny, you know, because when I did the TV show, I was much younger. And so to see, they keep replaying them, though. So if I see it, you know, or see a picture, I'm like, oh, just because, you know, when you see a picture of yourself from when you were younger, the whole world sees mine, you know? So it's like, I have a good sense of humor about it, but sometimes it can be fun to laugh at, you know. But I still enjoy watching the show if I ever catch it on TV, because I think it's funny and I have really good memories, you know. And I think that it was a great launching pad for other opportunities for me. I don't know. You know, right now, since I've been touring so much, that's really where my focus is. There's nothing like playing a live show. It's like crazy to see all the fans there, and it's instant gratification, you know, and it's so much fun to make a record and all that stuff. But I think if I had to choose, you know, for the rest of my life, I would probably choose acting, because I don't know, I can't see myself like 30 or 40, you know, still touring and living out of a suitcase, because I hate that.
Hillary, I have some questions for you. Your favorite animal?
A dog.
Your favorite food?
I think it's a tie between Mexican food and sushi.
Your favorite Disney movie?
That's a good one.
Princess.
Maybe Bambi.
Your favorite actor?
My favorite actor. That's so tough. There's so many good ones. Let me think.
Brad Pitt? No.
Maybe Johnny Depp. I like him.
Oh, it's very nice.
I like Benicio del Toro.
Okay. Your favorite actress?
Rachel McAdams.
Your favorite singer?
Oh man, I don't have one. Probably like Robert Smith from The Cure.
Your favorite place in the world?
My home.
Okay.
Being at home.
Your hobbies?
I love to swim. I like to drive my car. I never get to drive because I'm always out of town.
Okay.
So when I'm home, I really like to drive.
Okay.
And I do a lot of Pilates, and I like to go to the beach, and I like to shop.
Okay.
And I like to crochet.
Okay.
And sometimes I go out like dancing with my friends, and I go bowling a lot. So I don't know.
Where is your best friend?
Best friend?
Yes.
Well, my sister's my best friend, but then also my other best friend, her name is Taylor, and she's a really good friend. We've been best friends for like 9 years.
Hillary, thank you very, very much for this interview. I have this for you. It's a t-shirt from my program. It's Talking Stones, you know?
Oh, thank you so much.
Okay, this is for you, and I want to autograph her for Tapping Sound, okay?
Que vino todo aquí a México y súper linda la chava. Platicamos ahí unas cosillas. Vamos con Hillary Duff.
Vámonos con Hillary. ¿Qué?
Duff.
Ah, en exclusiva.
Hillary Duff, nadie la tiene, nomás las hijas.
Claro. Pues, a ver qué dice. ¿Se cree la muy?
No,
¿cómo es?
Súper linda. ¿Sí? Está bien chiquitita, me sentí así un monstruo al lado de él.
A ver, vamos a ver a Hillary.
Welcome to Mexico.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
It's good to see you here.
Thank you.
I was wondering, you've been working since what age?
Let's see. I've been trying to work ever since I was about 9. It wasn't work though, I loved it.
Was something you wanted to, or your mom told you, like, look, it'll be great for you to be on TV and do this and that, let's go and cast?
You know what, I grew up in Texas, and so that was never even... It didn't even come into my mom's mind, you know, like that's just not what people do there.
How did it came into your mind?
Well, we went to a performing arts school, and we didn't go for that reason. We just went because it was the best private school. And my sister got involved. She auditioned for a school play. It was a Romeo and Juliet play, and she booked a really big part in it. And so she was all excited, but she's like, Mom, I don't want to be embarrassed in front of my friends and, like, forget my lines or, like, be a bad actress, you know. And so my mom was like, I don't know what to do, you know. And there was this acting workshop that was not too far away from our house. And my sister saw it one day, and she begged my mom. She's like, please let me go take classes there just until the play's over. And my mom was like, okay, why not? You know, and my sister always did ballet, and I always did gymnastics. And so we had a lot of after-school activities. And then my sister loved it. And within, like, a month of going there, she was, like, her personality just, like, expanded. You know, like, she wouldn't be shy. She would go talk to anybody. She would come home and, like, play all these things that she would learn in class, like exercises and stuff with me. And so I was like, I want to do it, too, you know, because she's older than me. So everything that
it's
she...
There's only did, the two of you?
Yeah, only us two.
That's why you're so close to.
And we're only 2 years apart in age, you know, so everything she did, I wanted to do. And we would see little things posted on the board of, like, random auditions for commercials or modeling jobs. And... change your life if you want it. You can change your clothes if you want it. If you change
your... Did you miss out on something because you were working all the time, even though you liked it?
Well, let's see. I was in Texas and...
You missed school. That's cool.
Yeah, right.
What did you do with the first money you earned?
It's funny. I'm not too extravagant, you know, like I have a nice house and like I like to shop. I'm always thinking like, oh, but that's going to be too expensive. They have no shield, no secrets to
reveal. It doesn't matter what they say. Do you like when people like, you know, it's quite hard sometimes because you're on the tabloids and they say, hey, Hillary is fighting with this and that. And what do you care about it? Is it true? Do you get hurt?
I cared at first, you know, but what was it, like 4 years ago when I started fighting with, like, every girl in L.A., you know? It's, like, crazy.
And you did fight?
No. I was being sarcastic. Would seem like, all these stories would come out, and I'm like, what are they talking about? You know, like, it's really hurtful at first because it's so high school, you know? But I have to deal with the whole world talking about it and saying things that aren't true and supposedly this happened, that happened, and I don't even know any of those people, you know? So now I just laugh at it and I just don't even buy it or read it, you know? But at first I was like, oh, so embarrassed.
Tell me, how did you lose so much weight? Because you lost a lot of weight.
I did.
Do you have a special diet or something that you can tip us? Give us a tip about it.
You know what happened, actually, is I was filming a movie in Toronto, and I was walking down the street, and a paparazzi guy took a picture of me, and then it was on the front page of the newspaper the next morning, and it was like, Hillary Duff puffs. She must have gained 20 pounds. And, like, it sounds funny, but I was so embarrassed. And then after I filmed that movie, I was going on my summer tour with my best friend, Taylor. And we're like, this summer, we're going to get in shape. And we're going to, like, eat really healthy. And we're going to exercise a lot. And we're going to get in shape, you know?
Is your best friend? Since when?
Since 9 years ago.
What places do you like to hang out in LA?
My house. There may never be a sign, no flashing neon
light, telling you to make your move. What do you like about Mexico?
I like the food.
Tequila?
Tequila?
Yeah?
No.
Mezcal with the worm. Have you ever tasted?
No.
I should have brought one.
Wrong. No way.
It's the most disgusting thing you've ever eaten.
Have you ever heard of calf fries?
No, what's that?
What's that?
Calf testicles.
No!
Yeah, it's really gross. This is the thing. I was like 8, and we would go to the rodeo each year, you know, because I'm from Texas. But this is actually in San Antonio. And so we would be eating at the restaurant, and my parents would always order these things. And we thought they were chicken fingers.
Oh, my God.
Fried, you know? They just taste
so
like...
So they don't come like in balls like this?
Kind of.
Like the balls.
Kind of, but like chicken nuggets. Like, it's like resemble chicken nuggets. And then finally, like 3 years, we've been eating these and loving them, you know?
Do they taste good?
Well, I don't want to say it now because they're just disgusting.
Well, now you know what it is, but did they taste good? You taste
yes,
them?
Yes, I ate them for like 3 years.
He likes them. Mm,
I don't.
Look, I have a little present for you that we made. It's a brand from here that we have, our own brand.
Cute.
I hope you like it.
Oh my gosh, Royal Closet. This is very cute.
I heard you like, look. Well, I saw you like them.
This is really cute. Thank you.
Some chocolates to break up. Let the rain fall down, wake my dreams. Oh, this is Mexican candy. Don't... You know, here in Mexico, we like chili, hot stuff. Yeah. We make candy out of it. So be careful with it, but it's not a joke or anything.
I Hola, I'm Hilary Duff and you're watching Teleheat. It's hard to explain, you know, because when you're up on stage and you get to look out and see all those people and the way that they look at you and the way that they know every single word and you know, some people are crying, and it's really exciting to see people so pumped up to see me, and it's kind of unbelievable in a way. You know, I'm like, is this, why me? Like, is this real? You know, but I've never been here to do shows, and both of the shows that we've done so far have been really big, and way more people showed up than we expected, you know, sellouts, and it's incredible. I feel really thankful. I think it's definitely hard, you know. My life is so different from anything that I could have even fathomed when I was younger. You know, when people are like, well, isn't this what you wanted when you were younger? I'm like, I didn't even know things like this existed when I was younger, you know. So I am lucky to have really different experiences, and but it can be tough to deal with, you know. It's not normal, and I think sometimes it gets to you a little bit, you know, and you have to just take that time to take a break if you're feeling worn out, or have people around that you can have fun with and that you know care about you. Or a lot of the times when I tour, I bring my dog with me, which is nice, you know. And I do a lot of Pilates, and I like to go swimming. I think that's a really big release for me. It's definitely a different concept for a CD, you know. It's not a greatest hits, and it's not a full album, you know, of new songs. It's really weird the way that it came about, because I went into the studio with Benji and Joel, and we recorded these songs, and it was just like I had a couple days off, and we did it for fun. It wasn't serious, you know. My label didn't know too much about it, and then once I was finished with the songs, I had about 2 weeks before I left for my American tour. And they were like, well, we want to use this stuff, like we really like it, but we don't have time to make a full record. And so I went into the studio and we took some of the songs from the previous records and remixed them to sound a little bit differently, and put those songs out instead of just releasing a single with bonus tracks. And it was really just an experiment, you know, because we didn't really know what people were going to think of it, but we got really lucky. And people bought it and loved it, and it was great for the tour, you know, because I got to sing the new songs. I'm excited. I'm really pumped up. I know a lot of people that have played shows here before, and they just rave about the crowd and the audience, and I already got to have a little bit of a taste of it when I was in Monterey and in Guadalajara, and I'm excited. I can't wait. The fans are really pumped up, you know, and that really makes it possible for me to have a great show. So it's great to see everybody singing along, see their faces and the signs, and it's great. Very hard. I like so many different kinds of music, you know. I can't choose. I'm really into a band right now called Travis.
Okay.
And they're
They haven't done anything in a while, I don't think, but they have a really good album that I'm listening to. They're not my favorite, though. I don't have a favorite. I like all of them. Oh, when I was in Canada, there was a show going on playing at the same venue, but just the night before me, and it was Bon Jovi, so we saw a Bon Jovi concert. Music-wise, I don't know if I have a guilty pleasure. Maybe I like Marvin Gaye, but I mean, he's great. You know?
And about movies, a very, very bad movie or...
Very bad movie. Well, I don't think it's a bad movie. I think it's a great movie. But Drop Dead Gorgeous is a movie that came out, and it came out a long time ago, and it didn't do very good at the box office, and people didn't really get it. But I own it, and I watch it all the time, and I think it's great. I think you just have to watch it more than once to get to know it. But every time I mention it to someone, they're like, oh, that movie? What? But I love it, and nobody should ever watch the movie with me, because I sit there and like say all the lines out loud, and they're like annoyed with me. Why didn't I get this song?
Yes.
There's a song by Vanessa Carlton, and I know her, you know, and she's a really, really nice girl, and she's so talented. I love her music, and she has a song on her most recent album, and it's called Who's to Say? And I always think that if I had to choose a song of anyone else's to record, it would be that one. I guess it's just a difference in preference, you know, on the type of person that you want to be or how you want to live your life or how you want to be seen, you know. A lot of people don't really have any problem with opening up their whole entire life and their all of their problems or whatever it is they have, you know, going on. They want to live it in the public, and, you know, if they feel comfortable with that, then that's fine. Like, that's their choice, you know, more power to them. But I don't know, I care so much about my family, and I don't feel like I have to go out and party all the time or whatever, you know, like I like being at home and spending time with my dogs and spending quality time with my family or my close friends. You know, I don't have a ton of friends either, and I don't really like to, when I'm not working, I feel like I work so hard that when I'm not working, I don't like to go places where, you know, there's going to be a lot of cameras or I feel like I'm going to be working. So I guess it's just a difference in what I like to do, and maybe, I don't know. It's hard to say, it's just me, you know?